extension. All of you welcome about tension. Today I would like to discuss about the basic physics about the fabric extension. Okay, can anyone can come here? Bubble it. Bubble it. Did you observe anything here?
Feelings.
Did you observe anything new here?
Design.
What the design?
What the design? I'm just blowing the vision. Then bubbles are coming out.
Bubbles are coming out. Okay, now can you tell me the shape of raindrop? Shape of raindrop?
This is
rain.
Rain.
What is the shape of raindrop? What is the shape of raindrop? Yeah, very good. Spherical, right? So look here, I'm using this bubbler and I just bubble it. But whatever it may be the shape of this plastic, but bubbles are coming out in spherical shape, right? Doesn't seem interesting, right? It may be the square, it may be triangle, whatever it may be the shape of this plastic, but the bubble comes out in what shape? In what shape? In what shape? Spherical shape, right? Okay. You are all familiar with the raindrops. If I take anything, any liquid, if I allow any liquid drop by drop, again, what is the shape of the drop? Spherical. So the question is why? Why? That's what I am going to discuss about. The question is why it takes always a spherical shape, not triangle, not rectangular, or whatever it may be the shape. Okay. Okay, that's what I am going to teach you. Let's go through some images. So after that, seeing images, I will explain what is the surface tension is. Okay, can you also clearly, can you see here? These are small insects, so it may be the spider, it may be ant. Okay, you know what happens when spider or any ant or any small insects, when they used to walk on the surface of water, you know the beauty of the physics is their leg don't immerse in the water. That's the beauty. If I allow a spider on the surface of water itself, it can easily walk on the surface of water. Okay, the question is again why? Okay, you can see I can place a needle on the surface of water easily and the pin is also same. Okay, yeah, you can see the again the shape of the drops is in spherical shape. Okay. Next, again, this is the same thing. And if I allow any oil on the surface of water, can you come here please? Okay, pour this water into the What are you observing here?
It was very cushioned, but it flowed on the water.
It's just a form thin film. Don't you think so? It's just forming a thin film on the surface of water. It is not dissolving into the water, right? And you can see that. It's just forming a thin film on the surface of water. It is not dissolving. The question is again, why? Okay? If I immerse this brush, you can see this is the brush, okay? You can tap the volume or any something. If I immerse into the water, what happens? If I immerse into the water, what happens? It contracts. Don't you think so? It contracts. So before I immerse in this brush, it spreads like this, right? So if I immerse into the water or into the paint, whatever it may be, so the shape, it contracts itself. Did you observe?
Yes.
Okay. Okay. The question is again, what? The question is again, what? Why? Okay. So let me explain why it also, if I allow any insects or anything on the surface of water, it can easily walk on the surface, even the leg don't immerse into the water. Okay, I'm going to take one example. I am taking one beaker here, okay, and water here. And you know the chemical formula of water, this is nothing but H2O. Okay, this is a pure water, not immersing anything here. Okay, so all of you know this is a pure water. So molecules are like this. I am just writing here a few molecules here. Okay. All of you know about familiar with the molecular force of attraction and the bonding, all the things. Okay. So that's why I am going the detail. That's why I am going in detail with the molecular force of attraction. Okay. Look here. If I select one molecule inside the water, is it free? Is this molecule is free or bonded to the levels. It is bond, it is making some bonding with other molecules which are surrounded to it. Right? Okay. Okay, if I take here, what happens? Again, the same thing happens. If I take in the beaker, in the surface of the beaker, there are two things, the wall of the beaker and the water. Are you observing here? Just imagine there is a thin layer on the surface of a beaker. If I consider a molecule on the surface of beaker, what happens? The molecules of water is here, not here. Again, the beaker comes there. Okay, that is called adhesive force, that I will explain. Okay, I am taking a surface of water here. The molecules on the surface of water, are you getting what I am saying? Okay, I am considering the molecules on the surface of water. Okay, look here. This is the surface of water. Okay, if I consider, if I look here, this is the molecule way like in on the surface of water, not here. Okay, this is the surface. If I consider molecule here, what happens? There above this molecule, above this surface, above this layer, there are air molecules. Okay, so if I consider like this, even molecules are considered under the air rather than the kelagade iruvanta molecules. Now the force apply aagutte yavudu mele, on which surface molecules, not surface, surface molecules mele. So if I consider here, again it happens. Okay, so if I consider all the molecules which are present on the surface of water, it experiences, they experiences downward pull, downward force. Okay, so because of this force, this first layer of the water or first layer of any liquid behaves like a membrane. Are you observing or you understanding what I am saying? So if I consider the molecules on the surface of water, it experiences a downward force, it experiences a downward pull. So because of this, the layer, sorry, the surface of water or any liquid behaves like a membrane, behaves like a membrane. That's why a lightweight water spider or ant, whatever it may be, they can easily walk on the surface of water. You know the you know one thing, mosquitoes lay egg on the surface of water easily. The egg doesn't immerse into the water. But if I add some impurities, it goes easily into the water and it goes die. Okay, so anyway. Okay, are you understanding what I am saying? Okay, if I consider this layer, all the molecules which are present on the surface of water feeling or experiencing downward force. Okay, so if I take one drying drop here, if I take one drying drop here, okay, I will show one image here. This is the drying drop. If I consider the molecule inside the drying drop, what happens? This is inside the drying drop. Okay, again the molecular force of attraction is all in the, it's covered in all the direction. But if I consider in the surface, if I consider in the surface, what happens? Only the force is like this. That's why this layer behaves, or this surface behaves, or this surface has a tendency on guna irakidakke, entha guna, entha property, entha tendency to contract the minimum area. And you know that spherical has a minimum surface area. Mathematics teacher can say spherical has minimum surface area, minimum area. So that's why the water droplets or any liquid, if you allow droplet drop, it takes or the bubble again, if you bubble it, it takes what? Spherical shape. It has a tendency to contract to the minimum surface area. The property or the tendency to contracting to the minimum area is called the surface tension. Surface tension, why the question is, surface tension means the tension is acting on the surface. Basically, if I ಏನಾದರೂ ಒಂದು ದೊಡ್ಡ ಹಾಕಿದ್ರೆ ಈ ಥ್ರೆಡ್ ಗೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಟೆನ್ಷನ್ ಹೆಂಗ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ FIL ಆರ್ M ಇಂಟು G ಇತರ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಸೊ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಟೆನ್ಷನ್ ಗೆ ಬೇಸಿಕ್ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ಏನು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಪರ್ ಯೂನಿಟ್ ಲೈಫ್. ದಟ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದ ಡೌನ್ವರ್ಡ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಆ ಫೀಲಿಂಗ್. ಓಕೆ, ಅ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ನಾವೇನ್ ತಗೊಳ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಟೆನ್ಷನ್. ಯು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್?
Okay.